हाई स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेकेंड ईयर कॉमर्स क्लास. इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट लेवल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एज वेल एज डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन और से कंपैरिजन बिटवीन मैनेजमेंट एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. इन अवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ मैनेजमेंट, हाउ इम्पॉर्टेंट मैनेजमेंट इज for the organization. We have learnt how it helps in achieving our goals, how it coordinates, etc., etc. So now I told you that the best principles of management can be applied only in a group activity. Particularly in large scale companies we can apply the principles of management. What are the principles of management? We discuss in the next class. So whenever you consider a large scale business organization, maybe a joint stock company or a multinational company, how many levels of management will be there? That is very, very important. Particularly this class I would like to tell you about your career opportunities and where you want to be. Okay, this is not, I told you many times, second year commerce syllabus is not just framed to get marks in the intermediate public examination. This syllabus gives you the guidance about your career, where you want to be, what are the skills you should induce and improvise in your personality, what should be your destination, okay, what should be your goal. So these concepts will tell you where you want to be after a tenure of 8 to 10 years of your education. So whenever you take the management levels in any organization, particularly joint stock companies, multinational corporations, we see three levels of management: top level, middle level, lower level management. These are called as managerial levels. If you see this triangle, okay, what do you observe? A top level management, as this area is small, only few people will be there. Okay, only few people will be there at this top level. Little more, and here more people will work. Lower level management, you can see that extension of the box. Too many people will be here. Not rather than writing more. So too many people will work at the lower level management. Who will be there? What is actually a top level management? What is their task? Why they are given the priority? Similarly, you see payment also. Pay will be very high here. Okay, high, low. This is, I am talking about payment. Payment for top level management is very high. Okay, here high, here it is low. Clear? Why? How the payments are fixed, how the salaries are fixed? You all know that. It is based on the skills, based on the contribution by that person to the organization, the salary is fixed. Okay, it is quite naturally, if an employee or a manager or the top boss play a very, very important role in the success of the organization, naturally he will be paid more amount of salary. If he is very ordinary person, he will be paid only ordinary salary. Okay, so here, because it is an employee is a service provider, no? Okay, the maximum, the better service you give, you are rewarded in a better manner. If your service is of ordinary quality, low level, you are paid lower salary. So it is direct proportion. You are extraordinary, you are paid extraordinary salary. You are ordinary, you are paid ordinary salary. So you decide where you want to be. Clear? So payment will be very high for the top level, moderately high at middle level, and very low at the lower level management. And who will be there at the top level? What are the qualifications and qualities you should possess? Let us discuss. Top level management includes board of directors. In short, we call them as BOD, board of directors. Who are the board of directors? Ma? Who are the decision makers in a joint stock company? As we have learnt that in case of corporate business units, like joint stock companies, the company is managed by the team of board of directors plus managers and various other persons. So these board of directors are the people who take the decision regarding the business operations of a company. Then MD, managing director, CEO, chief executive officer, and GM, general manager. Okay. So these people, what they have to do, what is their job, why they are paid very high salary, is by virtue of their skills, by their experience, by their academic qualification, they know how to fix the objectives of the enterprise. What do you mean by objective? Goal, aim. What you have to produce, what is the service you want to provide, how many units you have to manufacture, where your factory is to be set up. All these things they can decide. They have got that experience of planning your objectives. So many times I told you in your first year classes, if we do not have objective, if you do not have goal, you can't perform anything, you can't achieve anything. So first of all, you have to define your goal. What I want to be, where I want to be. Okay. So for any organization, your job does not end by just investing money and creating the infrastructure. You have to plan your objectives. What is to be done? What are your goals? What market share you want to capture? How many number of units you want to manufacture? Everything you have to decide. So fix the objectives of the enterprise. Then evaluating the achievements of enterprise. Okay. The duty of these top level management does not end with only setting the objectives. After setting up of objectives, these people have to evaluate. Evaluate means find out to what extent you have achieved the goals, what extent you have reached the target, what are the reasons for success and failure, whether you have achieved the target or not, whether you have reached the destination or not. If reached, if achieved, fine. If not, analyze what went wrong, who is responsible for that. Okay, thorough examination. What is evaluation? For example, you people write the examination, we evaluate. That means how many answers you have written correct, how many are wrong, what is the formula wrong, what is totaling wrong, then we give the marks. So similarly here, we set the target. So how many of the employees have reached the target, how many of could achieve the objective. So we evaluate. Then for failures, again we prepare strategies. For success, we appreciate. So that is the goal, target of top level management. Then comes middle level. What is this middle level? By this triangle you can see. Middle level is the bridge between these two. Okay. Middle level act as bridge between top and low level. So whatever the top level management plans, these people will communicate. From these people, middle management will receive the orders and they communicate to the lower level management. So the responsibility of middle level management is to act as bridge of communication between the lower level and the top level. Top level people make the policies, but exactly they are to be implemented by the low level. So how to implement, how to guide, that is the responsibility of middle level. So middle level management acts as a communication bridge between top level and lower level management. Yes, who will be there at the middle level? Who are called as, who are part of middle level management? The heads of various departments. Heads of various departments means purchase manager, sales manager, finance manager, production manager, personal manager, that is HRM, human resource manager. Okay, I told many times, various joint stock companies, in order to execute their plans, in order to perform in a specialized manner, in a professional manner, very big companies which can afford the salaries of experts, they appoint a specialist person for a special department. Accounts manager, who should be an accounts manager? A qualified chartered accountant who is well versed with Companies Act 1956 and various provisions of assessment of tax. If he is appointed as accounts manager, he will provide you better service. If an ordinary person is given the job of accountant in your organization, he don't know how to finalize, how to find out profit or loss, how to assess the tax. So unfortunately, you may end up with paying high tax to the government. That may be a loss to your firm. So that is what is the duty of the chartered accountant. He has to assess. He has to see that all the business transactions are recorded in a proper manner. For everything, there is an evidence. All accounting books are maintained in a proper manner and will try to minimize the tax. That is the role of chartered accountants, by making use of various provisions available in the Income Tax Act. That's how why the chartered accountants are in high demand. Now, so we will have finance manager, HR manager, personal manager is also called as, then marketing manager, sales manager. These are the experts in various departments will be working at middle level. Then the last one, low level. Who will be there at the low level? Superintendents. Means who can supervise, or say who are the head of a particular sub-department, or the head of certain number of employees, then supervisors. Again, these people monitor the activities of the workers, and foremen. Normally in a manufacturing concern, a supervisor is called as a foreman, under whom some number of workers will be working. So he will guide the workers how to work, and he will be controlling their activities. He will be telling them how to work. If they are not doing work properly, he can have control over them. He sees that the rules and regulations of the organization are followed in a proper manner. So that is the rule of the job of the supervisors and foremen. So these people have got direct touch, direct contact with the executors, direct contact with the workers. So these three levels of management are there. Now, coming to your future plan. If you are a ordinary student, where you complete your just graduation, like you have completed intermediate, by this March or April you will be completing your intermediate, then for 3 years you will study your graduation, or according to new educational policy you may go for 4 years of graduation, you complete your BCom, or MSc students may go for a BSc, MECS, some course, some graduation, some BBA you have done. So where you will be? You will be at this level. Okay. At most you may be a supervisor, or some improvement you can become a superintendent. So with normal graduation, with graduation you will be here. So what happens? Your salary will be very low. Your salary will be very low. Otherwise, if you add up some extra qualification, like BCom plus CA or ICWA or ACS, you will reach here. With just BCom, you are here. In the coming 3 to 4 years, if you work hard, you sacrifice all your entertainment, television, what I told last year, all functions, etc. You add up this additional professional qualification like CA, ICWA, ACS, okay, you will reach middle level. Okay. Then, plus, apart from this, after having this qualification, plus, if you complete MBA from a business school, particularly at the international level, or IIM, Indian Institute of Management by writing CAT or MAT, by completing CAT or MAT, that means this is the admission test and you enter into IIM. From IIM you complete MBA, have 2 or 3 years of experience at this level, you will reach this level. So imagine here, Satya Nadella. Earning almost 1 crore per day. His salary is around 500 crores, as you all know, you can Google it. 500 crores is all incentives, perquisites, salary put together. Satya Nadella's remuneration from Microsoft is 520 crores or something. Okay, Sundar Pichaiya is earning around 260-270 crores. Shivanadar is earning around 180 crores. Lakshminivas Mittal, all these CEOs. Okay, Satya Nadella is the CEO of Microsoft. So almost 1 crore per day. That is called very high pay, I told. Why? Because he has done all this. They have done their IIT. Though they are from science side, they have completed their BTech from Indian Institute of Technology, then they have done their graduation or say management studies in a foreign university, entered into the organization. See, you need not enter at top level at the very first step. It may be difficult directly to enter at this level. Remember this. You cannot enter into any organization directly at this level. There are only few exceptions. Only few people may get direct opportunity to enter at this level. So first what you have to do, by having some professional qualification, you first enter at the middle level, you show your performance, then you can be elevated to this level. So 1 crore, so for some people, for ordinary people, for these people it is a lifetime. For low level people, 1 crore earning, they may require one entire life. 60-70 years of their earning may not get them 1 crore rupees. But whereas this for this person, it is one day matter. See, what is making the difference? What is making the difference? What is taking you to this? It is not the lift, it is not the staircase, it is not the lucky draw. It is the qualification taking you there. You don't require any political influence. You don't require any recommendation. You don't require any bribe. Only by virtue of qualification. These are the steps. This is the ladder. When you want to climb up, what is the foundation for you? What is the step? What is the basis for you? How, based on what you are climbing? You are not jumping. You are going through stage wise. Now you are nothing. You are at intermediate level. After few years, you will complete your graduation. So during graduation only, you register for these certificates, these courses. ACA stands for Associate Company Secretaries, CA, ICAI, that is Chartered Accountancy. Then ICWA, some other courses are there, you can join. Diplomas in Financial Management, then this one also we have got in our college, ACMA, so or CMA, so those courses will take you there. Imagine the person who takes a lifetime to earn is earned in one day at this level. Clear? Just last night, around 16 hours back, I was traveling with one of the guy who has done his MBA. He is working for Venkateshwara Hatcheries. So he is at this level, normal worker level. Even though he has done his MBA, because he does not have proper qualification, for Venkateshwara Hatcheries he is working. So his salary is 14K ma. 14K. So we were discussing about a person in that same company. So he is the GM, general manager. He told that his salary is 2.6 lakhs. It is a small company, Hatcheries. So where is 14,000 and where is 2.6 lakhs per month it is? So it is almost double, 20 times, 14,000 and 2.6 lakhs. What made him that person? General manager? Qualification. So you people also concentrate on this don't blame the others. COVID has come, no offline classes were there, we could not go to college, we could not meet lecturers, all that bahana, leave it. Gather the books, read newspapers, watch television, industrial debates, learn about the Indian economy, learn about the world economy. Okay, chew the newspaper, chew the books, digest them. So that will take you there. Understand? So these are the three levels of management. I wish at least some of my students will reach there. At least in the instance stage, they go here, then they reach this level. Okay. Unfortunately, I could not go because we were not given this guidance. We don't know what is this. What is required also, we were not told. Otherwise, I would be here. Okay. So these are the three levels of management. Now, let us discuss about management and administration. Many people think that both are same. No. Administration is a little bit broader concept than management. Whereas management is more in execution, administration is that which focuses on drawing the framework. How the work is to be done, okay, what is to be done to achieve something, what are our goals, how an enterprise is to be established, what can be the overall target of our enterprise. So administration is much broader. So management is part of administration. Like Telangana is part of India. India is not part of Telangana. So administration is India, management is Telangana. Try to understand this. So management is part of administration. So what are the major differences here? Administration lays down broad goals. So what purpose your management was, your enterprise was established. So those goals are fixed by the administration. Then what does management do? Management formulates plans to achieve goals. Okay, once the goal is given, how it is to be achieved, in what way we can achieve, those plans are formulated by the management. Then administration lays down broad policies and principles for guidance. So I told you many times, if you do not have principles, if you do not have policies, you cannot achieve the targets. So for achieving targets, you should have proper framework. So administration does that. Then administration draws out framework, management controls and supervises the activities. When framework is done, then management will control, means we'll see that all the employees are working according to the guidelines given by the administration department. Then administration provides direction, guidance and leadership, whereas management coordinates the various activities. About this, we have discussed so many things about coordination, direction, guidance and leadership. Administration is superior. Management works under the administration. So go through these points. In our next class, we'll discuss about principles of management, very important topic. Okay.